joining us on our second weekend of reopening. Thank you for your patience and your cooperation in all of our new procedures. And as a reminder, please make sure you are on our Flock Notes communication platform, because that's the main way in which we communicate with you during this time. And also the bulletin is electronic, so please check our website for the bulletin and upcoming news. As a reminder also that your orders of worship, you may take them home after Mass today or recycle them in the blue bins at the doors. Thank you for joining us, and please stand as we form assembly.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Tablets. Having come down in the cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground and worshiped. Then he said, if I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along and now accompany me. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And second, that I stand in solidarity with those who are peacefully calling for the end of this indignity in the streets of our cities. And that we, as members of the body of Christ, cannot continue to condone degrading attitudes towards our sisters and brothers in the world. You know, I spent some time reading that short pastoral letter against racism by our U.S. bishops, entitled "Open Wide Our Hearts: The Enduring Call to Love." And I encourage all of you to read that document. It's only 32 pages. That's short, so please take some time to read that short letter. In it, our bishops call on the Christian community to combat racism with love. And when I read that, I said, aha, that is how I will preach about the Holy Trinity. Because through love, we can understand who God is. Because love is the nature of God. You see, as Bishop Barron always preaches, he says that love is not primarily a feeling, but rather love is an act of the will. Sacred scriptures say that God is love. So if there is supreme love in God, that love cannot be love of himself. God is one, but not solitary. Because true love is always towards another. This helps us understand the plurality of the persons in God. That the love of the Father is poured out towards another. And who is that other? The Son. But because in God there is ultimate happiness, the love that is given towards the other is reciprocated. The Father pouring out his love to the Son, and the Son reciprocating that same love. And that there is a mutual love between Father and Son. And that bond we call the Holy Spirit. And that is why, for God to be supreme love, there must be a third person in existence to be perfect. The love that God gives to another and reciprocated cannot be perfect unless it is shared towards another, a third person. And therefore, God is a community of persons, or we can say communion of persons. God is this perfect community that communicates selfless love towards each other. But here's the beautiful thing. God is perfect within himself, Father, Son, and Spirit. But because his love is abundant, he needed to pour out that love even more. And therefore, he creates out of nothing. God creates the world out of nothing. Because of his love. This outpouring of his love creates the world and human beings as the crown of creation. In order that he could pour out his love towards a rational being, someone who is capable of loving back. And so then we can understand who God is and understand who we are through that. That we are made in God's image and likeness. Therefore, we share a common origin and equally made by God. But you know what happened? Not after creation. The fall. We no longer live in that love of God through the fall, therefore being banished from the garden. But you see, as I preached before, I never saw the banishment from the garden as merely a punishment. But rather, being banished from the garden as an act of love. So that God can redeem us and restore us once again to His perfect love. And so, then we are entered into salvation history. And throughout salvation history, God pursues His people out of His love. But time and time again, we fall into sin. We fall into worshiping other gods. That He had to send His only begotten Son, and the Son accepts to become a human being in loving obedience to the will of the Father, so that all men and women can be saved through Him. He does not hold on to His equality with God, but empties Himself, coming in human likeness. And we know what the Son did through His mission on earth. And when He finally revealed God's love on the cross, His mission was complete. And after completing His mission, He sends the Holy Spirit. But the Holy Spirit does not speak on His own, but takes on what is the Son's and declares it to His disciples. Each person of the Holy Trinity is attuned to each other in loving and perfect harmony. But what does this all mean for us? We are called to be perfect as the Heavenly Father is perfect. And God's way of being perfect is being in relationship. This relationship is a community of love. The love between the persons of the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Spirit, is a model of selflessness. Our likeness to God is the selfless gift of oneself. This way of being perfects our call to be holy, but also inspires and challenges us to love God above all, but also to love one another. Remember, love is primarily not a feeling, but love is an act of the will. This means that to love is to will the good of somebody else. To look beyond ourselves, beyond our ego, and say, I really want what's good for you. And so if we are to participate in God's very life, and to love, we must will the good for everybody. For all those who are different from us, from those who are still being oppressed, those who are being unjustly discriminated against. That is who we are called to love even more, to will the good of them. And so in terms of the Black Lives Matter movement, we should love and care for our brothers and sisters who are still experiencing racism in the world. You know, our bishops who wrote this letter says, love also requires us to invite a change of heart in those who may be dismissive of others' experiences or whose hearts may be hardened by prejudice or racism. And so if we want racism or systemic racism to end, both in the church and outside of the church and other institutions, we need to start here and now. Huh? You know, I saw a video of a nun who was responding to all the protests, the riots, and in her own way, sends a message to the whole world. She's in this full habit, but she's spray painting a board that is covering the wall. And I believe it said what she was spray painting. If we want change, comma, change must begin in your heart. Huh? And I said, that's it. It needs to begin in our own hearts. We must continue to change our hearts to more like the Father's heart. One that is always pouring His love towards the Son, and the Son pouring back that same love. Our Gospel says, my dear brothers and sisters, God so loved the world that He gave His only Son so that everyone who believes in Him might not perish, but might have eternal life. And so, just like the Father, may we, too, love the world and everybody in it, no ands, ifs, or buts, especially those who are different than us. This is what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. May we heed the words of St. Paul today to mend our ways, to encourage one another, but most importantly, to live in peace. And so let us now proclaim what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. To the merciful and gracious Lord of all, let us pray.
For our church and in the community, that guided by the Spirit of God, we may not harbor judgment and condemnation, but seek instead reconciliation and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve the church as pastors and ministers, that they may proclaim the great love of God, the love revealed to us by Christ Jesus, and now present among us in the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations and peoples of the world, that they may recognize the sacredness of God's creation, and work together for its just use and protection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents, teachers, and all who are entrusted with the care and education of children, that they may help our sons and daughters grow in God's ways of compassion and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, and the dying, that they may live in the hope of the risen Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our benefactors, friends, and supporters, that God will reward them for their kindness to us and continue to bless our ministry, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers on our website and for those we now mention.
To the end for this the end of this pandemic, for those who have been affected by it by illness or death, or affected by the pandemic in indirect ways, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the repose of the soul of Genoveva Bueno, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord. Lord God, Father of us all, hear the prayers we make to you for every member of the human family. Open our hearts to your Spirit, that we may seek an end to bitterness and discord, so that we might become your holy people, a community of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Of your glory, we believe equally of your Son, and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance, and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim.
Until the hour when we stand before you
saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John Henry Newman and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us once again on our second Sunday of reopening. And thank you for your cooperation and patience. We are currently working on a different way of signing up for Mass to make it easier that you just click from the email on your block notes. So expect that this week. It's no longer Sign Up Genius, but through block notes you can sign up for Mass. So please, if you haven't been receiving block notes, please see Sean after Mass so that you can receive all our communication. Have a blessed week, everyone. Thank you for those who are joining through our live stream. And have remember to be lovers in the world, meaning willing the good of others all the time. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your love.